Good morning, church. It's Thursday morning, and we're going to look at the Word of God, Revelation chapter 10, verses 1 through 7. Remember, with all the terrible things that are happening on the earth, ever so often, John gives a parenthetical statement showing from heaven's point of view what is actually going on the earth as far as, is Christ in control or is Satan in control? So in chapter 10, beginning in verse number 1, the apostle writes, I saw still another mighty angel coming down from heaven. Now, some debate that they think this is Jesus himself, an angel simply meaning messengers, but says another mighty angel. And others say, well, no, it can't be another if it's Jesus. And so some believe it's Jesus. Others believe that maybe it's Michael, the archangel, who has always been the defender of God's people, the protector of Israel. Either way, this is a mighty angel. This is one angel who has authority given by God. And he's clothed with a cloud, and a rainbow was on his head. His face was like the sun, and his feet like pillars of fire. He had a little book open in his hand. Now, all those things seem to point to Christ in some of the descriptions about Christ, and it may be, but I still believe that it's probably just an angel. But I want you to notice what he does. And he sat in his right foot in the sea and his left foot on the land. That is, he stepped down and put his foot down in the sea and then one foot on the land. Now, what is happening here is this angel or this individual, if it's Jesus, is bringing the deed to planet Earth, and he is claiming it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In other words, all the sea and all the land. Remember, God had told Moses to said it to Abraham as well, about wherever you place your feet, I will give you this land. And so he is coming to claim back planet Earth. Now, that's already been accomplished in the death and resurrection, but it's showing us here that even though it seems like Satan is in control of this world, that he controls the kingdoms of this world, and that everything is just turned loose and he is now doing whatever he wants to do, it's letting us know that, hey, we're about midway through the book of Revelation here. Jesus is still in control. This is still his land. And he says that he cried out with a loud voice as when a lion roars. Again, that could represent Jesus. When he cried out, seven thunders uttered their voices. And when the seven thunders uttered their voices, I was about to write. So he heard some voices and thunder, and he said, I comprehended what these things were saying, and I was about to write these things down, but I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, now not the angel who cried out, but a voice from heaven. So again, I believe this is Jesus in heaven that's telling him now, don't write these things. Seal up these things. And remember, that's what God said to Daniel. Seal these up to the end time. We don't know what was spoken here. We don't know what was said. And it's not important for us to understand these things, or whether or not these voices that were heard were angelic voices for good or angelic voices for evil. They were crying out because this angel has just declared war and victory on Satan. And so he says, don't write them down. And the verse 5 says, the angel whom I saw standing on the sea and the land raised up his hand to heaven and swore by him who lives forever and ever, who created heaven and the things which are in them, and the earth and the things which are in it, and the sea and the things which are in it, that there should be no more delay. But in the days of the sounding of the seventh angel, when he is about to sound, the mystery of God would be finished, as he declares to his servant the prophets. So remember, we're looking at the mysteries of God, and this certainly is one of those mysteries. Why is sin running amok? Why is there Satan and his hellish demons are doing whatever they want to do, and people are suffering on the earth? Why doesn't God come and take control? Why doesn't God do something about all this? Well, he is in his time. And notice he says in that verse number 6, there's not going to be any more delay. In other words, we've reached close enough to the end of the 7-year period that God is about to pour out his last woes, his last judgment upon the earth, and bring all things to conclusion. And Jesus will come again and establish his kingdom upon the earth. And so he's just letting us know that even in the midst of all the chaos, confusion, and seems like the darkness on the earth that's going on, Jesus is still the one who rules planet earth. Let us pray together. Father, we thank you that you are in control of these things. And Father, even today, whether there be COVID or whether there be floods or hurricanes or tornadoes or droughts, it just, whatever happens, we know you're in control. This is your planet, and you're only allowing things to work out according to your perfect will. That gives us such great assurance and confidence that we can walk today and not worry about anything. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.